Folks, the vaccine. Let's expose the vaccine drama. And everybody's blaming everybody else, right? Kejriwal is saying, if you're asking us to defend ourselves against vaccine, would he makes an analogy? Would you want us to buy the tanks in case Pakistan attacked us? Interesting analogy, right? Way off the top, but interesting. Point of the matter is, there is no vaccines available globally. I mean, he's dumped it on the states. That's a convenient so that he can go and preach everybody that it's the worst kind of the biggest event in the world. But that's nonsense, right? Why it's nonsense? Why you should know? Firstly, India was, before this started, 70% of the production global capacity was with India. We had a running start. But what happened? Between August and November 2020, European Union ordered 800 million vaccines, right? US 400 million, which is almost 1.5 times the amount of the population. UK 150 million. And guess what India ordered? 16.5 million folks. And therein actually lies the story. And so when you hear all this nonsense, government in talks to boost vaccines arsenal, Pfizer can supply 5 crore shots but wants norms ease, Moderna jabs only in 2022, Russia studying vax requests from state. You know it's all gobbledygook, especially Sputnik, folks. Sputnik, another story. 70% of Sputnik's production is supposed to be in India. Out of that, only one doctor, Reddy Lab, has got 150,000 doses. Who are Sputnik and the Russians fooling? Who are we all fooling? I have no idea. But these are telling comments, right? India yet to avail World Bank funding for vaccination. World Bank has 12 billion vaccine purchase fund still available for country. India has received 2.5 billion to deal with COVID fallout. India, which is currently facing a shortage of vaccines, has the option to seek funding under the World Bank 12 billion bank purchase fund, but so far has chosen not to do. The point is, we need that money. We need to, like I said, till this you see this money flow to whatever people, right? Nothing is happening. It's all talk, just like I said. No alternative to producing vaccine. India is best place for vaccines. What's happening now? But this is the challenge. Vaccine supply. Pfizer wants pre-order advance payment. This is really it, folks. And they're not getting it. Nobody's getting it. Supply lag temporary. All will get vaccinated fairly. There's this guy called Arya Sharma. What do you mean fairly? Let's get enough of them. Why? You know, now they're going to change from adequately to fairly. Watch these gloopy-gop Sharma's, man. And what do we have? Abdiyanath. Abdiyanath says second COVID wave blunted UP in safe zone. But can you trust this guy? Right? Especially when you have the center in UP gives different vaccines in first and second jabs. If you have that kind of stupidity happening, do you expect him to give the real numbers? You make the call. And what Gujarat High Court says? Is vaccination a 5-year plan? You know the way these guys are going, I think that's what it is, right? But you know the confusion. Pfizer says can give 5 crore doses in July, October, Moderna next year. But Pfizer is saying, you give me indemnification. Not happening. Work hard offers to make 2 billion COVID vaccine doses. Yeah, all these guys are offering, but they need money. Advance money, folks, advance money. Till you see that money flow, everything, folks, is a lie. Or they'll say we'll vaccinate fairly, but the point is, let me tell you an anecdotal incident yesterday. Yesterday, I met somebody at the DEFCON market, and he was basically organizing a vaccine, co-vaccine for somebody's maid, right? And they were getting it for 1500 rupees in some part in Delhi. And he had the audacity to make a statement, Kejriwal to aise hi bol raha hai, vaccine to sabko mil raha hai. Here lies the story. Vaccine jo paise dene wale hain, un sabko mil raha hai, sir. But jaise milna chahiye sabko, jo duniya bhar baki hai, unko nahi mil raha. Ye game uski hai. Aap ye nahi keh sakte ki Kejriwal hi kar, wo sach hai. Jinke paas paise hain, unko mil raha hai. Wohi to kar chuki hai sarkar. Discrimination. Fairly kehte hain wo log. Kahan hai fairly? Okay, WHO not likely by September, says Bharat Biotech. Well, till then we can't travel. Global tender, Maharashtra, BMC gets 8 bids each, none from manufacturers. Obviously, manufacturers no money, everybody else is flying the kite. Rates and bids are far higher than market prices, says Rajasthan Minister, which is true. Pfizer cites Indian origin of UK test subjects, all clear for children to seek faster approval. You know, this is the thing, India sits in its ivory tower, has done no goddamn tests, has done no genome sequencing, and doesn't even run trials, and basically has the audacity to say, hey, but get our trial report. But the world, if you're trying it, like this Pfizer rightly says, if you're trying it in the United Kingdom, enough of the subjects would have the Indian DNA, wouldn't they, right? But look at this. Reliance, he'll get what he wants, right? RIL rolls out mega vaccination drive. Inoculation may cover 1.3 million persons. Company talk with AZ, Gamaleya as part of community. So he's going to pay top dollar, and he's going to get the vaccine, obviously. But this is what it is. Atam Nirbhar Bharat. It's not reliant on government. Oh, then you have US vaccines to contain deaths, not pandemic, WHO. So this is really it. We could have squeezed the deaths. And that was the reality. That's where there's criminal negligence, folks. More after the break. Got to touch on federalism and the latest elections because of what's been happening in Lakshadweep, which is extremely dangerous. But listen to this out first. Sickly system, healthy democracy is what Ruchir Sharma said. Elections held during deadly pandemic surge exposes India's real flaws and strengths. I don't know whether it exposes any strength, but definitely a lot of flaws. Those of us who see these as dark times for Indian democracy can take heart from the recent elections, not only because of the way regional parties stood up to the center's ruling party machine, but also because of the highly unusual nature of their win in the key battleground states. Kind of interesting, right? Interesting take, if it had not left so many deaths and destruction. Poll results show the power of federalism. This is what Mark Tully says. He said in my last column, I warned that the results of the West Bengal elections could further undermine India's federalism and take the country one step closer to becoming a one-party democracy. Mamata Banerjee's sweeping victory has shown that even an election-winning machine as well-resourced and as successful nationally as Bharatiya Janata Party could not resist Bengali federalism, right? So, if opposition parties now formed a federation, there would be rivalries over the leadership, but if they can put those to bed, it's okay. Then he says, however, restoring spirit of cooperative federalism, because that seems to have dissipated totally. He only spoke his mind. It would have been better if he talked and listened about work. At the end of the week, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee had a similar complaint following the Prime Minister's meeting with district authorities. The criticism does confirm an impression the Prime Minister gives of being someone who prefers to talk rather than listen. He's known to have listened to very few people before taking two of the most crucial decisions of his time in office, demonetization and the imposition of national lockdown. In Delhi, where the BJP faced a humiliating defeat, the Home Ministry chose April 27th, the height of the oxygen and bed crisis, to bring into effect the legislation which undermines the elected government of the city. And this is very critical to understand. Cooperative federalism is a great idea and is the need of the hour. Unfortunately, it is easier said than done. And that's what happened in Lakshadweep is what you need to note. What does this happen? What happened in Lakshadweep? Tackle the brewing discontent. Lakshadweep's administrator Praful Khoda Patel has kicked up a political storm with a set of decisions that the government claims will trigger further development in the union territory. Only money for the majority community, which doesn't exist. But critics slam as undermining the political, cultural and economic makeup of the islands. For one, Mr. Patel has curtailed the powers of the panchayats, bringing health, education, fisheries and animal husbandry under the administrator. This has reportedly, the same thing in the Delhi model, right? This has reportedly led to many engaged in these sectors on a contract basis being laid off. Two, while the island has been free of COVID-19 for almost a year, Mr. Patel's decision to lift the stipulation for mandatory quarantine for travelers from Kochi is attributed as a key reason for a surge in cases. The archipelago has now had over 7,000 cases. Three, the island, which has an overwhelming Muslim majority, also faces a draft regulation against cow slaughter, though beef forms part of their daily diet. Besides, Mr. Patel's actions being undemocratic and unpopular, any unrest in the island have implication for India's maritime security and could open up the door for external mischief. And the jihadis and extreme Islam is looking for any fuel to add fire. And you're giving them this. And you've got Maldives right next to it. This is a place where China has got its eyes wide open, folks. And you have a person like Patel, another Gujarati. I don't know what to say, right? But in Lakshadweep, 8 quit BJP in Lakshadweep as unrest grows. 8 quit BJP in Lakshadweep amid unrest over new laws. Row intensifies as Lakshadweep BJP president joins growing chorus, right? And you know, this is what happens. This is what the government is really interested in. Police scan almost 2,000 CCTVs to arrest 3 men for cow slaughter. No concern about anything else but cow slaughter. Hey, give me that any day. Police bust cow slaughter racket, 3 arrested. And the whole process is union territories are being absolutely mishandled by the center, whether it's Delhi, whether it is now Lakshadweep. So the other is this governor business. And I've said this always needs a relook, right? Stop counting sheep. Put governors out to pasture. I absolutely agree. And who's the person who said it? Inderjeet Hazra. Surely the bear didn't believe just because he got his orders from Government of India, he'd be ordered around by it. Unbelievably. As a belating encounter fraught with center, state tension attested, it's time we quit wasting taxpayer money on the upkeep of folks cosplaying Curzon Minto Mountbatten. And that's true, folks. In Bengal, lot of Habardabar, not able to live without you. Didi, BJP leader who quit TMC. Center accords Y plus security to Suvendo's father plus brother. These are ex-TMC guys. Where are we going, folks? Another TMC rebel requests return to party. Things are not happy in Bihar. JDU MLA questions Bihar's health infra. And what does this guy say? Jita Ram Manji. Put PM Modi's photo and death certificates to BJP ally Manji. That's what people are thinking of him, right, folks? He said, why arrest some of and spare others in Narda cases, Supreme Court? Talk to farmers or face bigger stir. Kisan body writes to PM. This is the other big things that are happening. Farm unions write to PM Modi, seek resumption of dialogue. Farmers to mark 6 months of stir with Black Day today. Singu Tikri, Ghazipur, black flags mark the day. Will protest till 2024 if needed, says Tikkaid. Farmers in Punjab, Haryana hoist flags to protest agri laws. will hold protest till 2024 if necessary, says Mahendra Singh Tikekar. This is what he looks like. He's becoming a sardar now, folks. So here, folks.
Satta mein andhe hokar itna kursi ka lalaj 36 saal ki umr mein maine nahi dekha itna andha pradhanmantri itna andha grihmantri इतना अंधा स्वास्थ्य मंत्री, आप ऊपर से नीचे तक फेल हो चुके हैं। ये नकली भाई और बहन कहने वाले लोग, इनकी आदत है लाशों पर सियासत करना।
ये और थाली बजा के प्रधानमंत्री से कहिए, गो प्रधानमंत्री गो। हमें
सो फॉक्स टोटल अंडरएस्टिमेशन ऑफ डेथ्स एंड दैट इज अ ट्रेजेडी फॉर दिस गवर्नमेंट। NYT talks to experts, gives three estimates of actual India toll. He says syndication arrangements put together these estimates by talking to more than a dozen experts, including Dan Weinberg of the Yale Public School of Health. He says the report points out that while official figures miss death all over the world, the undercount of cases and deaths in India is most likely even more pronounced. A second scenario, which the report describes as a more likely scenario, takes the actual infections at 20 times what's been detected by test sets of 53.9 crore. It assumes an IFR of 0.30 in line with what has been estimated in the US at the end of 2020. That gives a figure of 16 lakh deaths or over 5 times the official count of 3 lakhs. This is what the reality is, folks. And here we go. Why we must count COVID dead. Center and the state governments must ensure real-time release of death registration statistics. It will capture true scale of tragedy, enable better planning to manage future waves. And he's analyzed Gujarat, which is totally underreported, right? And Christopher Jaffrelot writes, why this is happening? Because we've become prisoners of nationalism. It blinded the center of COVID's devastating second wave. He says, Modi asserted with some bravado that India has won the battle against COVID-19 when other countries are still struggling. And therein lies the problem and the hubris of nationalism, right? On Twitter, a self-quote, he says, it has put the Ministry of External Affairs in a spot for a job of defending India's actions against a big tech firm will end up falling on External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar, currently on a visit to the United States. There is a simple lesson, stay focused on beating the pandemic, fight political wars without involving state agencies, and remember, each action will be carefully weighed on the scale of democratic conduct, okay? And Modi ji comes out, as a game, you know, Vishwa Guru, we're not Vishwa Bikaris, right? We're not Vishwa Gurus anymore, we're Vishwa Bikaris. Our planet won't be the same after COVID or Modi, you know, or both, I don't know, right? What he says, rumblings grow with Karnataka BJP. And that's the trouble really happening within the BJP, right? What else did he say yesterday? Gratuitously, crocodile tears. Some people say maybe, you know, we shouldn't play into his hands by fingering him on tears. And that may be right. But these tears are all made up. We now have a better understanding of COVID, which boosts strategy to fight Prime Minister. Having killed our economy, having killed over 1.2 million, having provided no vaccination, we now know better. The rest of the world had actually taught us if he was just listening. Now, what does Sardesai write? For PM Modi, the 7-year itch. Modi too now faces this moment of truth. His initial appeal was drawn from his claim to being an anti-establishment folk hero, a man from humble origins who combined religio-nationalist zeal with the image of an anti-corruption crusader and a development icon. All trash. But the case of rising flames and crematoriums make public relations exercise look terribly jarring, insensitive, distractions, etc., etc., etc. Jai Hind, folks. You make the call on our PM or PS, whatever it is. Cheers.